This will be the perfect video if you are looking to build any applications in Bubble. Today I'm going to be showing you how to build this awesome little application here in the next 42 minutes. So what we're going to be able to do is create a task. It's a little, you know, task management software similar to Trello. Create titles, description, categories, and then we can edit those tasks. We can move them, you know, to in progress, to completed. And then we're also going to be able to go in here and delete the task. So feel free to go ahead and build along with me in the next 42 minutes while we go through here and build this pretty powerful tool that you can use for your applications. Enjoy. Cool. So one of the first things we're going to do here is change the layout of our actual page. So 1440 to give us plenty of space here. All right. And now let's go ahead and make this align to parent. In most cases for your guys' applications, you're gonna have, you know, a row or column, but in this case, since we're just building, you know, the task management portion and that's it, we'll just do align to parent, make it nice and simple. And then we're gonna go ahead and create a group. We're gonna put it right in the center. This is gonna be a group column, perfect. Minimum width, let's just do 12, no, max width, I mean. Let's make that 1280. And then for now, we'll just make this 800. Actually, let's do 600. Now let's change this to 800. All right, perfect. And then we'll just rename this to main content. Cool. So this is where all of the content is going to be contained within. So we're going to go ahead and start with the text box. I'm going to go and throw it in there. Let's remove this extra width and height. We do fit with the content. And then this you can display dynamically based on the user. You could do welcome back and then current user's name if we actually did that. In this case, I'm just going to do, just put it in manually, Kobe. And let me get that emoji that I use. A little wave. Nice and trendy. So we'll go ahead and make this like heading one. Now it's going to be a little big, so we'll change this to 32 pixels. Bold is fine, and that should be good. Perfect. All right, before we get too ahead of ourselves here, let's go ahead and work on the data. So the first thing we're going to do here is an option set. So this is going to be a static data type, is essentially what you could call it, right? And so for our project management feature we have here, there's the to-do section, there's the in progress, and there's completed. And then our tasks are going to be, you're going to fall under one of those categories, right? And so we're going to start with that, and we're going to go category, create, and then we're going to go ahead and we're going to create a new option. It's going to be to-do. So those are the ones that are in the to-do category, in progress, and then we have the completed, right? Cool. So all of our tasks are going to fall under one of those options. And then to our data types, we're going to need to create a task data type. And within the task data type, we're going to have a few fields. We're going to have the title of the actual task, which is going to be text. We're going to have the description, which is going to be text as well, right? So these are the different fields within the data type that we can display on our actual application. And then we have the category, which we just created, the option sets. And instead of choosing one of these basic types, we can actually choose that option set. So now we have a dropdown of each category that we can select for each data type. And the last thing we're missing here is the due date. So we're going to do that, and it's going to just be a date. Cool. And that's, you know, it's fairly simple. It's essentially all we need for the data. For the data types for the actual application we're building here. So now we'll go back to design. Next thing we're going to do is create a container to contain all of our sections, our to-do, our in progress, and our completed. So with that, we'll just label this as group sections. And this is going to be row because they're displaying from left to right. Column's going to go from top to bottom. So it's going to be a row container layout, and we can change this. We can just remove that for now. 60 is fine as a minimum height. Right, to just give us some space between the text and the actual sections here, we'll just give it a margin of 20 pixels. So that should be plenty there. The rest of this looks good. All right, cool. So now let's go ahead and build our first section. For these, we're just going to build it once, and then we'll copy and paste each section. Cool. So we got that group section to do. And this will be a column. Min width, we can delete. Actually, we could do 280 for now. That's fine. And then we're going to want some padding to give us some space between all of our, between the edges of our container here and the actual content. So we're just going to do about 14 pixels, should be plenty. So there's that. I also have a background color. Let me grab the one I already use. All right, cool. So background color, background style, flat color. And we'll go ahead and paste that in. D9, D9, D9. That'll be nice. Clean. I actually want to come back. I have a background color on the main page as well. We'll just do something like that. Won't be too bad. All right, going back to the actual section. Let's also add some roundness. Let's do about 20 pixels. Should be great. Make it look nice and modern. The last thing we'll do for this section here is just give it a min height of 600 pixels so it comes down a little bit. I'm just gonna go ahead and duplicate this, Control D two times, just so we can get an idea of what it's gonna look like. We'll come back and delete these because we will not need them because we're just gonna duplicate once we're finished. But for now, let's do that so we can kind of see what it's looking like. Let's go back to group sections. And let's add some spacing. It's going to be column spacing. Let's do about 20 pixels. Yeah, that should be pretty good. To give some space between each section. All right, so let's go ahead and create the group for the title of the actual section. So we're going to start with that. We'll leave it 60 for now. We can get rid of mid-height width. And then let's give its background color flat color. And then we'll do the one I'm already using. You guys can use whatever colors you want, or you can copy me. F0, F0, F0 with a roundness of 10 pixels. And then let's label this as group to do header, I guess, header section. There's that. And then we're going to need, actually, real quick. Oh, let's do that. Let's change this to row because we're going to have the to do. And then on the right side, we're going to have the plus button where we can create a new task. So let's do that real quick. So row, and then now we can add our text and let's remove all this extra width and height. We don't need any of that. And then center, vertically align it. And then we'll label this as to do. And then for the actual text size, we'll go ahead and do 18 pixels. And then for this, I kind of like to do an extra bold. Looks good. All right, cool. And then let's go back here. Let's get some padding on that left side. Let's do a padding of left and right of 20 pixels. And then let's also make this a little smaller. Let's make it 40 pixels. Let's go ahead and create the icon, the plus sign that we'll click on to create a new task. We got an icon here. Let's put it right to the right and we'll type in plus. Perfect, right there. And then we'll just change this to this text color we have, the 1F, 1F, 1F. And then layout, we want to vertically align that as well. I'm just going to delete all this padding. And then we'll go ahead and make it 24. That's a little big. Let's do 22. There we go. Cool. So that's looking pretty good there. I think that's still a little big, actually. Let's do 20. Yeah, I like that. Okay, cool. There's that. That should be it for the top section. Now, let's go ahead and create a repeating group. So what this repeating group is going to do is going to dynamically display the tasks that we actually create. So we've got a repeating group here. And every time we create one, it's gonna, you know, dynamically display it below each one, right? We're also going to filter out this repeating group by all tasks that have a category of to do. So that'll be awesome. So we'll be able to filter them out based on their actual category. So cool. So we don't want any kind of fixed number of rows. Columns are fine. Minimum height doesn't really matter too much because it's going to be growing with the content that's in there anyways. So for type of content, we are going to go ahead and select a task. And then we're going to do a search for type task, add a new constraint, and we're going to constrain this or filter it out by its actual category. So category equals, this is the to-do section, so we're going to select to-do, and then we will go ahead and sort by created date, and then we'll go by descending. So when we create them, you know, it'll appear on above it, right? And they'll continuously appear above them as you create them. And just for visual purposes, I guess we'll just change this to 100. Then one thing we want to do right off the bat here is get rid of these ugly separators. We definitely don't want that. We don't want this border here. So that'll be great. And then let's add a top margin of 14 pixels so that there's some separation between the header. Cool. So this repeating group is going to be searching for tasks that have the to-do category. Let's go ahead and create the cards that will be displayed. So we're going to take a group, we're going to throw it in there, and we're going to go ahead and title this as group task content. So that should be great. Awesome. Let's start by getting a background color of the white, and then we'll also add a roundness of 10, and then we'll go ahead and create some padding inside the actual content to create some spacing so it looks a little cleaner. Cool. And that should be basically it for the card. That's everything we need for the actual card element. Just double check in. We'll create conditionals in a little bit, so we'll not worry about that right now. All right, awesome. So now let's add some content to this card. Well, first thing we're going to do actually is go back to appearance type of content task, and it's going to be your current sales task. So that current cell is going to have a task that's displayed, and then we're going to pull data from that actual task, right? So now let's go ahead and create the title element. Let's remove all this fancy width and height, fit height to content. Cool. And then we're going to insert dynamic data. We're going to take the parent groups task and take their title, and that's what's going to be displayed. And then let's go ahead and change some of the styling here. We'll make it semi-bold, and then we'll give it about, let's do 20 pixels. That should be nice. So the parent group's task title is going to be 20 pixels, semi-bold, text color is fine. All right, perfect. Now we're going to want the description right below the title. So we're going to just duplicate it to make it nice and simple. We're going to change this to the description. And then let's go ahead and change some of the styling. Let's bring it down a notch to regular 400. And then we'll also make this 14 pixels. That'll be nice. Cool. And then we're going to go ahead and duplicate it. Actually, before we do that, let's create one more group within this card. The reason we're doing this is because at the very bottom here, we have the due date. And then to the right, we have the delete button. And if we don't create this group, right, it's going to have the due date and the delete button below it because the parent container is a column. And so if we create another group and make it a row, then we can display them from left to right for that specific section, right? So that'll be perfect. Row, group. We can just label this as a bottom section. It's nice and simple. Bottom section. And then we're going to copy this text, paste it in there. Before we do that, let's go back to the group, and we need to give it some content. So it's going to be a type of content task, parent groups task. Simple as that. And we're going to change this to the actual due date. So now the due date will be displayed there. Let's go back to this section. So I already got it as a row. Okay, perfect. And then minimum height, we can remove that. minimum width, we could remove that. All right, cool. So now we need to go ahead and add the icon, the trash icon. So icon, boom. Let's see, we got trash, wonderful. And then we'll change this to that text color. Remove this padding because we don't need it. And we'll change the size to 16 pixels. Cool. So now we have the delete button where we can actually delete the task that we see here. All right, so let's go back and create some spacing between these elements. We'll give a top margin of 10 there. And then something like 5 should be fine for that element. There we go. One last thing we'll do. So as we can see, the cards are going to be kind of displaying right next to each other. We want some a gap between those as well, right? And so we could always go and add a top margin of 14, and that would serve the purpose that we're looking for. But that's also going to add a margin from the actual header up here, which may cause some unwanted side effects, right? So what we could try doing here is let's go back. I know before we deleted the separator. So the separator is right here. We're just going to do solid, and we'll do the 14 pixels in width. But we're going to go ahead and make it 0% so we can't even see it. So that should give us some nice spacing in between each of our task cards. So before we actually add the functionality and the workflows to start creating, editing, and deleting tasks, let's add a few conditionals to make it the project or the application a little more interactive. And so if we click the plus sign here, we can add a conditional. And so what we want to do is when we hover over this plus sign, we want to change its color. So what we can do is we can click define another condition. When this icon is hovered, we can go ahead and change the icon color. And then the color we're going to use for this conditional is going to be something like 4A. Should be kind of nice there. Should change just enough to where we can see it. So let's go ahead and preview that. Let's see how it looks. All right, so let's remove this debug, causing weird spacing. So as you can see, when you hover over it, it kind of becomes a little lighter. Now it is a little abrupt. So what we can do is we can come back to appearance and we can add a transition so that that color change is a little more gradual and it eases into it. So now that we've done that, if you can see it, it's kind of hard to see, but it's changing colors gradually instead of abruptly. Yeah. Awesome. And then we'll do the same for our actual card, our task card. And so we're not gonna be able to see this yet because we don't have a card created. But you could just follow along with me and then we'll go from there. And then we'll test it once we actually create some tasks. So this group is hovered. And then we're gonna change the background color. And then for this, we're gonna change it to be FB, FB, FB. So it's just a little darker, just a little bit. And then we'll do the same thing as the icon. We'll add the transition for background style. And then in 200 milliseconds, it'll change from white to the gray or to the grayer. Then in 200 seconds, it'll change from the white to that slight gray we have that we set over here. One thing I also forgot here, let's do this. Let's do. And then let's do parent group tasks due date. And then if we go to the rich text editor here, we can actually highlight this and bold it and then save. That just adds the BB code for the actual text. You could type it in manually here, which is fine as well. I always like just going in here because it's simpler and it'll automatically apply it for you. Cool. Take that layout. So let's make sure we center vertically align that. Cool. And then we'll also add the conditional for when we hover over the trash can. So we'll do conditional. And then when this icon is hovered, let's change the icon color to this red, this destructive red. So it also is, you know, a good UX feature to kind of remind them, hey, this is red, this is going to destroy something, right? Kind of like a warning in a sense. And so now when we hover over that, it'll give us that red color. Let's go ahead and vertically align this due date text as well. Alrighty, so we are getting close to adding the workflows and the logic and functionality and stuff. But before we do that, we do want a pop-up. So when we create, actually two pop-ups, but the first one's gonna be the one we use to create the task. So when the user clicks on the plus sign, we want a pop-up to appear so that they can create a task. So let's go ahead and do that. We're gonna click pop-up here. I'm just gonna add it to the page, nice and simple. We're gonna change the, actually first, we're gonna title it as create task, pop-up create task. It's gonna be a column layout. We're gonna display everything from top to bottom. We're gonna make it 400 pixels. And the minimum height 320 is fine. And then we're going to create some padding inside to get some spacing between the content and the edges. So like I said, the content's going to be displaying from top to bottom. That top section though, we want the actual title of the pop-up. And then to the right, there's going to be an X to close the pop-up. So for that, just like we did over in the card over here, we're going to create a group and we're going to make this a row, and then we'll just title this as create task top, because it's the top section. So we're going to do row. We're going to go ahead and delete this. We'll leave minimum height for now so we can add content to it. All right, cool. So now text, let's do that. Let's add the text in here. And this text, we're going to go ahead and remove all this min width and min height. And we're going to title it as create task. We're going to change it to bold and we're going to make it, let's do 24 pixels, should be plenty. All right, so let's go ahead and add the X icon. So close, change that color to this. And then we'll go ahead and remove, actually, we can leave that. That's actually a good size as it is. I kind of like that. All right, cool. And let's remove this minimum height now. Let's make sure this is all centered vertically. Perfect, so there's that top section. So now let's go ahead and create the input fields where we will add the content we need to add to our task, right? So to start, we're just gonna get a basic input field. And for the placeholder, we're just gonna do task title. So that'll be great there. And then the layout, we can make it not fixed width. And then for the height, we'll just do 40. I don't really like that, let's do 44. So that is the actual, that's the input we will use for the title of the task. Now we're gonna want a multi-line input for the description. So descriptions, are going to have a little more text in them, right? And so we want to make sure that we have the ability to have multi-line input, so it's not just one line. We can drop down a couple lines while we're typing it out to give us more space, essentially. We're going to delete that. 100 pixels, I think, is fine. So now what we're going to want to do is create a drop-down. This drop-down is going to allow us to choose where we want to send this task, right? Do we want it to be under the to-do category, under the in-progress category, or the completed? This will also be essential when we are editing the task, right? When we want to move it somewhere else. Cool, so for the placeholder, we're just going to change it to task category. So that's what we're going to be choosing. And then we're going to want to make this dynamic choices, and it's going to be our categories, right? Then it's going to be all categories. And then we can just change this to current options display. And then let's scroll down. Everything here looks fine. Let's make sure this stretches across so we can delete that. Let's change this to 44 to keep it all nice and cohesive. All right, the final thing we need is a date slash time picker so that we can choose the due date. So let's change that height. Let's remove this. So now we can choose the due date and we can go and customize the input placeholder and we could just do pick a due date and then the date format. You can choose whatever you want. I kind of like this one right here. Last element we need here is the button so that we can submit this input, submit all these input fields to create a task. So we'll just go ahead and change this to submit. And layout, we'll go ahead and stretch it across. 44 is already there, perfect. Just a few final things to wrap up this create task pop-up. Let's go ahead and select the actual pop-up. Let's go to layout, and then let's create some gap spacing between these elements. So we'll do about 10 pixels, should be plenty, to kind of give it some space to make it a little more visually appealing. And that should be good there. One last thing, on each of these tasks, or sorry, in each of these inputs, we want to make sure they're required. And so what you want to do is just click on it. This input should not be empty. So if we click the submit button and one of these are not, they don't have any content in them, it's not going to be able to submit to the actual form. So that'll be very important. All right. So now we need to go ahead and create the edit task pop-up. So we're just going to go ahead and make it nice and easy on ourselves. And we will just go ahead and duplicate the pop-up we've already created, because most of it's going to be what we're going to use anyways, right? So we'll just do, we'll change the pop-up to edit task. We're going to change the text here to edit task. And then this group here, we'll also change it to edit task top. Cool. Let's go back, because I did forget something. When we are creating our workflows and we're modifying data and we are editing data, these inputs are going to show up when we're selecting the data, right? That we want to pull from. And so we're going to want to differentiate it. So input title, this is going to be the create, right? These are going to be the inputs that we use for the actual creation of the data. So multi-line input, description, create, drop down category, create, due date, create. Let's go back to edit task. Let's do the same over here. Let's change these title, edit. And down on the button here, we'll change this to save instead of submit, because we're just saving the actual changes. So we're going to come back to this edit task pop-up, because we're going to want to change some things on what's actually displayed when this pop-up appears. But before we do that, let's finish a few more things that I forgot to do on the design side of things. So I'm going to go ahead and delete these two sections here. We're going to want to go ahead and duplicate the one we've already created to make it nice and simple. Boom, boom. And then let's change some of the styling. So for this one, we have in progress. And we're going to change the color of the text to white. And we don't need these icons. We can delete those. We'll change this background color to 49A9EF. Oops. I got 49A9EF. That's a nice little color. And then that should be good. And then let's do the same thing on this side over here. We're going to do completed. I'm going to change the color to white. And then make this background color 5CD059. Cool. So now we have all three sections. One thing we are going to want to do, though, is change the filtering for each section, right? So over here, if we go back to do, we search for tasks. We're filtering out all tasks that have the category of to do, right? So that's the only type of task that we're displaying. We're going to want to change that over here, search for tasks. We're going to change this one to in progress. So now it's only going to display tasks that have the category of in progress. And then for this section, we're going to want to change it to completed. So category is completed, then it'll display that content. My recording cut off a little bit, but it's just a small thing. I just changed the actual title of these elements to match up with the actual section, right? So we have completed header, in progress header, and then I also change this section in progress, section completed. This is essentially it for the actual design of this little, you know, application that we're creating. Now let's go ahead and move on to the workflows so that we can start creating tasks, editing the tasks, deleting the tasks, viewing the tasks, all that fun stuff, right? The first thing we're going to go ahead and do is create the workflow for creating a task. So when you click this little plus sign here, we want to be able to create a task. So the first we're going to do is click add workflow. And all we simply want to do when we click on the plus sign is show the pop-up for the actual create task. So we'll do show element pop-up create task. Simple as that. So we're going to pop up that pop-up. So we're going to pop up the pop-up. Let's make sure that's working. Let's go ahead and preview. Press the plus sign. Perfect. Create task. But let's go ahead and open up the create task pop-up. First thing, let's do this real quick. We want to click on the X and we want to be able to go ahead and close the actual pop-up. So this is nice and simple. I'm just going to go ahead and click add workflow. And it's just going to simply hide pop-up create task. And then we also want to just reset the inputs as well. We just want to reset the relevant inputs so that those get erased if we do close it out, so that if we open it back up, they don't pre-populate. So now we want to create a task when we click on the submit button. So we're going to click the submit button. We're going to add a workflow. And what we want to do is create an action. And under the data things tab, we want to create a new thing. We're going to create a task. And then we're going to go and add all fields. Now we're going to go ahead and assign these fields values based on what we typed into those inputs, right? So category is going to be dropdown, category create. See, this is why we label them differently, right? Because it's showing both dropdowns from both pop-ups, but now we can differentiate from the two. So dropdown category create value. The description is going to be that multi-line input description create value. So it's the value of that input. Date picker, due date create value. Title is going to be input title create. Value. When we click on submit, we're going to be creating a task. And then once we do that, we want to go ahead and just reset those relevant inputs. And we also want to hide the pop-up, right? Because once we create it, we don't want to sit there and stare at the pop-up, right? We want to see the new task we created. So once we click on submit, the pop-up for create task is going to disappear. So let's go ahead and test it out and see how it looks. So we're going to press the plus sign, create a task. We're going to type in finish UI for landing page, something like that. Get on the 21st, submit. And there we go. As we can see, now that we've created that task, it is now showing up under the to-do section. That should be all we need to do for creating a task. Now what we want to do is be able to click on the task and have the pop-up come up so that we can edit that actual task. So let's do that now. We're going to go ahead and click on the task card here, and we're going to add a workflow, folks. When we click on that, we want to show the edit task pop-up. All right, so when we click on that, we want to show the edit task pop-up, but we do have one issue. All right, so we can click on it, shows the edit task, but we want to push the data from that actual task into this pop-up so that we could come in here and change it and edit it and then save it. So the only way we are going to be able to do that is by using custom states. So essentially what they are, if you're familiar with programming at all, they're just variables, right? So when we click on this task, we want to assign this task as the custom state. And then we can use that variable to display in the actual pop-up. So what we're going to do is going to click on this repeating group here. We're going to create a custom state. And we're going to just name this edit task. And the state type is going to be a task. So that's going to be the state name, essentially a variable. And the type of content is going to be task. So what we want to do when we click on this card, we want to assign that card's task to the actual state. So it's going that, but first what we're going to do, so we're going to click on add an action, set state. The element we're setting a state of is going to be the repeating group. One thing we're going to need to do real quick, because we have multiple repeating groups here. We're going to want to go ahead and differentiate them. So this is going to be repeating group to do. Repeating group in progress. And I guess I technically should have done, created this custom state before we got to this point, because it would have copied and pasted over, but it's okay. We can go ahead and create it later on. So there we go. So now let's go back to workflow. We're going to set the state of the element to do. Edit task. So now what value are we going to pass to this custom state? We are going to pass this current sales task. Simple as that. When we click on this card's task has now been assigned to that custom state. And then now what we're going to want to do is display that data in this pop-up. So that's the next thing we'll do here. So let's assign some data to this actual pop-up. So it's going to be type of content task. The data source is going to be this repeating groups edit task, right? That's the custom state. It's the edit task. So now this pop-up is going to be assigned the data source of whatever card we clicked on. So now if we go to task title, we can change the initial content to be the parent group tasks title. And then for task description, we can change the initial content to be the parent group tasks description. Default value can be the parent group tasks category. And the due date for the initial content can be the parent group tasks due date. Wonderful. So now if we go back, let's refresh, boom, it assigned this task to the custom state, and then this pop-up is being assigned to that task, and then it's displaying that data. Now that the data is being displayed, we can go here and edit it, change it up for maybe the product page, right? We've gone ahead and changed that, but one thing you'll notice, it's not saving anything because we have not set up the workflow for that. We also have not created the workflow for closing the actual pop-up. So let's do that now. So let's do the simple one first and close. So we're going to do the same thing that we did before with the create task pop-up. We're going to hide the edit task. And simple as that. And then now let's create the workflow for the save button. So add a workflow. So when this button is saved, or when button save is click, we're going to want to make changes to a thing. More specifically, we're going to want to change the parent groups task. We're going to add all fields, and we're going to update it with the input fields that we have on the pop-up. This time we're going to choose the title edit value. Wait, what's going on here? That's not the title. That's why. We're going to choose the category. Drop down category edits value. And then we'll do the same for the rest. So when we click on save, it's going to go ahead and change the fields of the data of the actual task and assign it these new inputs. Now, if we go back and we could see that it's showing the initial content, right? So if we don't change one of these, then it's just going to reassign its initial data anyways, so that'll be perfect. The last thing we want to do is when we save it, we want to go ahead and hide the edit task pop-up. All right, so let's test this out. So we're going to go ahead and click on the card. We're going to finish UI for product page. And then now we can save it. There you go. It is now changing. We're now changing the task. We can also go ahead in here, change it to in progress and save, and then it'll appear over here. We haven't added the functionality for these sections to make the same changes. So we're kind of, it's now stuck in progress. So I'm gonna go back to our app data and edit this one. We're gonna change it back to do for our own purposes here. And now we're gonna wanna go ahead and add the delete functionality. So this is fairly simple. All we're gonna do is click on the delete button, add workflow. When this button is clicked, we're going to want to delete a thing, and we're just going to simply delete the parent groups task. So now if we press the delete button, it's gone. So that is essentially it for the logic. All we need to do now is kind of replicate a few things on these other sections. So let's go ahead and click on this card here for the in progress section, and we'll add workflow. And to kind of differentiate between these, let's match it up to the color we have for the design. So we have gray, blue, green. For this, we'll just change it to blue. And then we could just simply copy and paste these actions over to this workflow. Boom. And then let's do it again over here. Add workflow. Let's change this to green so we know that this is the completed one. Probably a little better if I went in here and actually labeled them differently. But for our purposes here, this will be just fine. But I want to go ahead and do the same for the actual trash button, the delete button. We could just click this one, copy, paste. We can make this color blue. And then we'll go back. Go to this right here, add workflow, paste, and then change this to green. Cool, so that's essentially it. We can create a task. We can move these tasks to, you know, in progress, to completed, wherever we would like to move them. We can click on them, change their due date. We can also go in there and we can delete them.